Hi, and welcome back to Energy Modeling Fundamentals, OpenStudio Basics. In this set of videos for set 8, we're going to go over basic HVAC systems. We'll be starting with packaged VAV systems, and the intent of this video is to get you to understand, or to share with you really, how the components in OpenStudio are available to you to build up systems piece by piece and give you some comfortable understanding of those components. So that way, when you do higher level functions, such as using measures or applying whole systems, you understand how those could be manipulated and modified in some method. So we're going to go over in a series of four videos these four systems. So we'll talk about packaged VAV first with reheat, and then we'll look at four pipe fan coils with boilers, chillers, and a dedicated outside air system. And then we'll look at two versions of variable refrigerant flow, one with directly ducted outdoor air, and then one that would have a dedicated outdoor air system. So to start, I have this schematic put together here that represents packaged VAV systems. And so in this building type, what we're looking at is a heat flow that basically moves heat from the space through, it provides, it moves heat from the space all the way outside. And then it also brings in fresh air and basically provides ventilation using that same system to the space. So we're going to have a packaged air handling unit. It will serve all the different zones with the different dedicated variable air volume boxes. We'll assign reheat coils to the boxes, and we'll talk about connecting those to a common boiler. And yeah, we'll just look at how this set kit of parts is represented in OpenStudio. And you could then go deeper and tune this. And I'm not going to go into all the details, but you could imagine you could tune the fan's efficiency, the DX efficiency, the variable air volume, minimum airflow rates, and so on and so forth. So in our model, so far we've added thermal zones and we've turned on ideal air loads. So to start with, we're going to turn off ideal air loads. So I need to uncheck all of these. We'll apply that to all, we'll turn all those off. And just to keep this simple, this was a model that had lots and lots of spaces. It's one floor. We're just going to assign them all right now to be on one system. And that'll just keep our model simple to demonstrate how these systems are configured. So as we go, so I click down here onto this loop that brings us to systems. And by default, it will always show you the hot water, the fresh water loop first. But inside HVAC systems, in this top right tree, you could see all the systems you have. These are the defaults that it always has available. Right now, we don't have any air conditioning systems. And so we would use this plus at the top. And we're going to go ahead and create. Here's some default systems you can add by object. So we're going to add package DX rooftop VAV with reheat. So if we say add to the model, this now created a number of loops. It created this air loop that's our packaged unit. You can see the cooling object, the heating coil, fan, a VAV box. This is the outside air. It also made a hot water loop. So it made a boiler, a pump, and a supply side, and then a demand side for the hot water. And this is the coil that's in the air handler, and this is the coil that's in the VAV box. And the way OpenStudio works is you can click on any object, and in the right-hand side, it will allow you to look at the properties of that object to edit the inputs, the efficiency, or how the unit might be auto-sized. So to get us started, what I want to do is assign our space type or our thermal zones to this package unit. So I'm going to click here on one of the left or the right-hand sides of the demand loop. You can see it then gives us, it shows us all the thermal zones we could add to this loop. So I'm going to go ahead and as I select each one of these, you can see it's just adding them to the loop. I'm actually going to take these off just for a second, just because let's say we wanted to change the minimum turndown to be 10% in these boxes. We wanted to have this be 0.1, not 0.3. I would make that change first, and now as we add new zones, it will copy the first one. So the second one now has 0.1% turndown. So there can be some advantages to making sure the very first VAV box or terminal object is the way you want them all to look. So we're just going to go through and assign all of these, and I'm going to pause and jump back in a sec. All right, so I have all my thermal zones assigned to this loop, and each one has a reheat box. And we can see now if we go to the hot water loop, it just added all these hot water coils for us. We didn't have to do that or change anything. So at this point, the model should work. I am going to make one adjustment in my rooftop unit. I don't want to have a heating coil on the outside air. It's not as common in California to have a heating coil here. So I'm going to just click that little X that deleted it. And then over here, I need to make sure it's deleted on this loop as well. I got rid of that little coil, so now we just have cooling, and then the zones heat. And I'm going to save this as our working version. This will be our package VAV model. And there's other properties we could adjust. Indeed, you know, we could turn the economizer on, set this to some reasonable upper limit, 75 degrees upper limit. Right now it has one. This is the set point that it's controlled to, and we could let's just keep this as a set point for now and see if the model will work. So before we run, we are going to add one what's called a measure to be able to look at the results in IP units. So you could do this at any time in running your model, but we're going to do it now before we go through this air conditioning system. And in here, we'll have another video on measures, but basically we're going to apply a reporting measure. And so we will apply, let's start by applying this OpenStudio results measure here. So I'm going to drag that object to this reporting measure window. Looking at the icon type, it matches. This is in my local library, but this same object is available on the building component library that we'll talk about later. So with that, we're going to run, and I'll pause here. All right, and our model is working. So you can see it sizing objects with the Santa Rosa weather file and basically going through the design days and now starting the annual simulation called Run Period 1, where we'll count through each month until the model is complete. So the model will run, and once it's finished simulating, you can see it took a minute and 22 seconds. It will then apply the measure. So it's applying this results visual measure and basically aggregating the output files. When it's done, it goes green, it says complete. We can then click on the results tab. And by default, it'll now show us this results overlay that we've created. So this is the OpenStudio results summary. It'll tell us about our building. It'll tell us the energy use intensity, so 30.96. And we could just scroll down and kind of get some high-level takeaways from the building. We can see we have lots of hours. The thermostat is not satisfied, so we'll have to go check that out. But generally speaking, we can start to see the energy use of our building here. So it'll show us kind of the end uses, heating, cooling, lights, and fans. It's the same. You could look at the Energy Plus file still. And now in the same view, you can see here's our fan energy, our pump energy, our boiler, and our cooling coil. All right, so before we jump to another system, let's try and understand the unmet hours challenge that is going on, that I noticed in here. So if we look at the output, if we look at this in more detail, and I've actually just opened this OpenStudio results view in an internet browser, you can find this file. We could look at the unmet hours and try and seek out why. So the goal in the model should be that during occupied hours, the thermostats are always satisfied. And this is saying that 1,400 hours, the heating system wasn't able to heat the building enough. So the first thing we would start with is if we look at our system, we didn't go into much detail on how the system is controlled. We just kind of added it and ran it. And so there are ways to look at the key things you would look at for this level of unmet hours would be we would look at the system. When does the system run? And we can see right here, if we click control, currently the HVAC is running all the time. It says always on discrete, and it's always at a certain supplier temperature. So this already indicates that this is a problem, because this means our building is 24/7, and maybe we should have a schedule that's in line with our thermostats to turn the whole building on and off. So I'm going to go ahead and make that schedule, because we'll need it for all the building system types. So if you recall, this is our cooling thermostat. And so what we need to make is a HVAC on-off schedule that we could then use to turn the whole system on and off. So I'm just going to make a new schedule. I'm going to do on-off. It'll add it up here, and we'll call this HVAC on-off schedule. And the way you edit schedules is we need to figure out what time we want to start. So the thermostats right now change at 6 a.m. So our HVAC should turn on an hour before at 5 a.m. It's a pretty long runtime, but for now let's just go with it. So if you double click, you can double click now and move this line to be zero, representing off. We'll pull this over to 5 a.m. and then we'll double click to add another line, and let's go check when the thermostats shut, when they flip back off. So this right now is at 2200. Yeah, 2200. It's a pretty long runtime. But again, we'll go to 2100 here and then turn this off. I think it was 20. That's 2200. Yeah, that's right. So this was set to 60. All right. So 22, our summer, we're just going to add a new profile. It should always run in the design day. It should always run in the winter. And now we have our default here. Let's see. We do have weekends. So this is Sunday. Looks like it's off. Saturday, the system runs at shorter hours. So we need to make some Saturday, Sunday. So we're going to add a few more days. We'll copy the default. And then we'll do it again. So this will be our Sunday. So we'll just move. We'll double click these to get rid of it. Sunday is now off. To assign this little purple one, you'd have to click the S. And you can see here all the Sundays now have that applied. Saturday, based again on our thermostats, on Saturdays, this starts at 6 a.m. and ends at 18, which would be 6 p.m. So we'll make our schedule go again to between. Priority 2 will be our Saturdays, 5 a.m., and we'll just go to when the building goes off, 6 p.m. Gonna save. And so we now have this little on-off schedule. We can now apply it to the system. So back here, I selected my system at the top when I went to HVAC. Click on controls, and now I can go to my model and select rule set schedules. Here's that schedule we made, and we'll apply it on top. I would say at this point we could also change this to turn the system off in case the thermostat deviates. So let's say turn the cycle on the system in case there's a call for heating and cooling. By doing that, it added this little nighttime availability manager by itself, so that's great. We'll go ahead and save. And we'll run and see if this fixed some of our unmet hours. All right, so I have figured out what has made our VAV system have so many unmet hours. And this is the there's some key things that you need to check if you're going to create a base HVAC system using this green button here. And we'll learn more of these things as we apply more systems, but there's some key critical things to check again on the VAV system. So, things we're going to look at, we're going to check the fan system, make sure the fan is set to run, that matches the thermostats, the same hours the air conditioning runs. We'll need to check a few other things. We'll check to make sure the system can turn on at night when maybe it gets too cold in the building. And then we need to check some temperature things in the model. Make sure the hot water is at the right temperature and our VAV boxes are supplying enough hot air. These are all different properties of a VAV reheat system. So the basic ones in the model under control, here's that HVAC on-off schedule. So we did that, we checked that before. Here's our nighttime run toggle. So this turns the system on at night in case it needs it to maintain the thermostats. The other thing I found was that the hot water system that we added, by default, when I went and looked at it, this used to be set to always making 150 degree water. And all our VAV reheat boxes were waiting for 180 degree water. So one thing to check here is always come into this hot water system and replace the controller. This used to have a different controller, so I went to the library and I added a set point to change the temperature of the hot water based on the outside air. And I actually went down to this one, reset. And this is in lots of different energy standards, but now the reset control says when it's 45 degrees outside, reset to 180. When it's 55 degrees outside, change the water temperature to 150. So make sure you change this. And then on our VAV boxes, I would remove all the zones and change the first one and then reapply them all so they all have the same properties. So for all the VAV reheat boxes, as a starting point, make sure they have these properties. So we can start them at a 10% minimum flow or 20%, whatever your design might be at. We'll set this to the damper heating action. So we'll set this to reverse action with limits. We'll set the air temperature to supply 104. And then down here on the water coil, also set this rated outlet air temperature to 104. And if we do that, we then can get a model that will meet our goal of trying to get to about 300 hours or less unmet or unsatisfied in our model. That's like a good range to start. So again, the goal here is to learn how to build these systems up. The other thing I found was that, again, when we apply, the other thing to check would be that I'll add to our list. Oh, yeah. Is check the air loop is not 100% outdoor air. So the default, when we added this system and you click on supply demand, I noticed that another default that was set was these toggles were set to yes for 100% outside air in cooling or heating mode. So change those to no. I don't know why they were set to yes. I also changed the fan static pressure to be 4 inches. You'll know, this will need to match whatever design system you have. Standard VAV systems are about 4 inches, maybe a little more, maybe a little less. But I noticed the default again here was set to 2. So basically the takeaway here is there's pretty bad defaults, and there's actually a way to apply a whole system, a packaged VAV system, instead of using this approach, through a set of measures. And when we get to the measures, we'll look at that, and those tend to be more robust and don't require so many small changes to make the systems work. But if we go ahead and ran it, I already ran this model, and now we can come down here and we can see that our hours out of range for heating are 144, for cooling 65. So that's a little bit more than where I would like it, but it's very close to 300, a good place to start. It represents that the model is working. All right, with that, we'll move on to the next system.